top data questions you can answer with the SAS Information Catalog. The SAS Information Catalog can help you answer these questions. What data is available? Depending on your intentions, you can search the catalog data by physical location or SAS library, table name or label, table type, file extension, date range, data size, or the number of columns. At the column level, you can search by column name, by column label, but also by classification label given by the catalog. For example, you can search using the semantic type, that is, if the data resembles a name or an address, the language detected, or the locale. The locale is a country language pair detected by the SAS Quality Knowledge Base. Where is the data stored? The location of the table or the file is shown in the overview screen or in the search list. Can you access this data? If you have at least read or read info authorizations on the CASLIB where the table or the file is stored, you can access the assets overview. If not, a message will tell you that you don't have sufficient permissions. What data is in the table or the file? The SAS Information Catalog is a fully fledged data analysis tool. It brings the power of analytics upstream when you perform data discovery. When you open a data asset, in 30 seconds or so, you will know what data is in the table just by looking at the summary. You will know the time period covered and also the areas covered geographically. The most important columns are highlighted, the storage format, and if outliers were found. You will also get a clear indication if there is any private or sensitive data inside. And what languages were detected in the text columns. Data quality metrics such as completeness are calculated in addition to how big the table is, the number of columns, the rows, and the size. What data is stored in each individual column? You can drill down into each individual column. Depending on the data type, different statistical measures and metrics are calculated. For a geographical point containing latitude and longitude, a map will be displayed with the most frequent locations. For long text columns, a word cloud would be displayed. For certain string columns, a sentiment analysis model is applied at discovery time. The language of the text may also be classified automatically. For numeric columns, a wide range of statistical analysis measures are calculated. Do you need to foresee extra data preparation or processing? Correlations and outliers are clearly marked for each of the columns. Column analysis in a data asset informs you if you can use the data for the purpose you intend to, or if you need to foresee some extra data preparation or data processing. The metadata measures will help you assess the structure of the columns, the data types, the logical type, the formats, the lengths, and so on. Is the quality of the data acceptable? The data quality measures will answer questions such as if the data is complete or unique, and if there are any interesting patterns in the data. Is there any private or sensitive data? When data is discovered, columns are classified semantically. The catalog helps you understand if there is any private or sensitive data inside your data asset. What other assets are available? In addition to data assets, the SAS Information Catalog helps you find non-data assets such as SAS models, data plans, studio flows, rule sets, and even code files. The catalog indexes these assets automatically. It acts as a unifying repository. You can therefore open each of the assets from the catalog, and you will be redirected to the SAS application that produced them. How are the data assets and other assets related? SAS Lineage complements the SAS Information Catalog. Lineage is providing you with a business impact diagram, which tells you how the assets are related. In this example, you can see a data plan which occupies a central position. Left of it, you can look at the source tables or the files used in the data plan. And right of it, you can see the output. So this is the data processing result. How has the data changed or evolved over time? Activate analysis history, and if something changes in the data from one moment in time to another, then you would be able to jump in time and see what the differences are. Can you trust this data? Users can add descriptions to a data asset or flag it. This helps centralize and store the collective knowledge about the data set in one place. Who's responsible for this data? The SAS Information Catalog might not answer all the questions that you have. Data assets allow you to keep track of the important contacts with the stake in that asset in an organization. In conclusion, the SAS Information Catalog can help you answer these questions. What data is available? Where is the data stored? Can you access this data? What data is in the table or the file? What data is stored in each individual column? Do you need to foresee extra data preparation or processing? Is the quality of the data acceptable? Is there any private or sensitive data? What other assets are available? How are the data assets and other assets related? How has the data changed or evolved over time? Can you trust this data? And who is responsible for this data, and where do you go if you have more questions? And that's it for this video. Now you know what top data questions you can answer just by using the SAS Information Catalog. Thank you for watching. Please do let me know in the comments if this was a helpful video. If it was, like the video and subscribe the channel. For more SAS FIRE tips and tricks, take a look at other videos in the SAS Technical Insights and Expertise channel.